General Rildo is far stronger than we previously thought. General Rildo was one of the more recognizable villains in the first saga of Dragon Ball GT, as Lord Lude or even Legic are usually forgotten about. But one statement from Goku has led General Rildo's power being vastly downplayed by the Dragon Ball community. Just because Goku said General Rildo was stronger than Buu does not mean that his power has to be somewhat up to par with the final villain of Dragon Ball Z, and what I will show you guys is that Rildo should be far, far stronger than even that of Buuhan. And of course, this will be shown through power scaling Goku and the villains he faced along the way between the Buu saga and his showdown with Rildo. So, to start off now is the actual end of Dragon Ball Z, where base Goku is actually likely stronger than his old Super Saiyan 3 self. Now, a lot of people say that base Goku is stronger than his old Super Saiyan 3 self in GT, which is true, but he doesn't first attain that in GT. He first attains that at the end of Z. At the end of the Dragon Ball Z, they are talking, and Goku thinks that someone besides him and Buu might win. And Goku is referring to Ub. He's saying that somebody else might win besides him and Buu, and he's referring to Ub. And when Goku and Ub actually go to fight each other, Piccolo said this is going to be the most anticipated fight. This is going to be the best fight. And Goku's fighting in his base form. Now, if Ub is showing that he's more powerful than good Buu, and base Goku is up to par with him, that means that this base Goku is already stronger than his old Super Saiyan 3 self, or at least as strong. Now, of course, you can't just take every statement as gospel. You have to try and bring in context to show that this is possible. And it quite is possible, because 10 years happened between the end of the Buu saga and the end of Z. And as we know, 10 years is more than enough time. For example, Goku spent 7 years in the other world, and not even just trying to get his power level higher, he tried to attain Super Saiyan 2, Super Saiyan 3, and learn from many techniques from all of the other world's greatest fighters in history. And still, in his base form in the Buu saga, is likely stronger than his old mastered Super Saiyan form in the Cell games. And here's a guide saying that Supreme Kai is likely relevant in power to Goku from the Cell games, and he is scared of Pui Pui and Yakon, and yet Vegeta, whose base is weaker than Goku, one-shots Pui Pui like it's nothing. So this shows that Goku's base form in just 7 years of training got at least 50 times stronger, but there's a lot of people out there who are believing that Mastered Super Saiyan is more like a 500 times multiplier, which means that Goku would have gotten 500 times stronger in 7 years, and Goku with an additional 3 years, he should be able to get to the level where his base form is as strong or stronger than a Super Saiyan 3 self. After the fight with Ub, Goku goes and trains with Ub for 5 years. 5 years of intense training. After these 5 years, Ub gets a lot stronger, but so does Goku. In fact, Goku in space is still stronger than Ub. Now, we can't really guesstimate or gauge how much stronger Goku got, but in 5 years of training with somebody who is Majin Buu level, he should have gotten a lot stronger, a whole heck of a lot stronger. And so this brings up a scale of, we have Super Saiyan 3 Goku, then we have base Goku end of Z, then we have base Goku at the beginning of GT. Now, when it comes to Goku getting shorter, getting shrunk to being a kid again, that does not actually decrease his power at all. What it actually does is decrease his stamina and makes it harder for him to go Super Saiyan at first. So base Goku, when he's a kid in GT, is still the same power as adult Goku at the beginning of GT, before he's reverted back to a kid. So Goku doesn't lose any power here, which doesn't break any of the scaling. Now, over the course of them getting the Black Star Dragon Balls, this takes place at about the pace of around a year, so Goku is getting stronger over this time. Now, at this point, Goku ends up running into a big baddie villain, Lord Lude. And Super Saiyan Goku, which is potentially 500 times stronger than his base, is nothing to Lord Lude. A Super Saiyan Kamehameha does not do anything to Lude. In fact, the only way they defeat him is by punching him in his weak spot, while Pan also punches at his weak spot from the inside, which causes him to be being defeated. So we have this amazing villain at Lord Lude being far stronger than a Mastered Super Saiyan Goku. We kind of guesstimate that this is a Mastered Super Saiyan Goku, because later on he still goes Super Saiyan 2 and Super Saiyan 3. And so let's bring this back to the scale. We have Super Saiyan 3 Goku Buu Saga, base Goku, end of Z, Base Goku, GT, and then Super Saiyan Goku, and then Lord Lude, final form, level 3 or whatever. And then now this brings us to a few months later in the first saga, when our gang goes to planets M2 and run into the Sigma Force. Now, this is something that Goku says about the Sigma Force. You guys are awesome, huh? It's been a long time since I met anybody as awesome as you. And he also just makes other comments about their power and how awesome it is. And now, this might mean that the Sigma Force is at the power of Lord Lude. And now, what might back this up is not only Goku's statements, but Dr. Mew saw Goku and Trunks fight Lord Lude as Super Saiyans, and still ordered Rildo and the Sigma Force to capture the GT gang. And also, Guru gave his data of Goku, Pan, and Trunks to the Sigma Force, and just everybody, and they were still confident that they could take Goku on in a fight, and that's even a Super Saiyan or a Mastered Super Saiyan Goku. And Goku, in his base form, is stronger than the Sigma Force, and then the Sigma Force fused together into their complete ultimate form, Super Mega Cannon Sigma, and Goku complements their power once again, and still has a pretty crazy battle with them where it's a lopsided one. Goku, in his base form, is far stronger than a fusion of all of these beings that might be stronger than Lord Lude. After Goku pretty effortlessly defeats the Super Mega Cannon Sigma, then that's when General Rildo comes into play, and we get to see General Rildo's amazing power. So, Goku says, "What is that key? It's huge. It's an incredibly huge key heading towards the spaceship. This one doesn't even compare to the guys we've had up to now." Now, he also comments on General Rildo's power, and says that he's even stronger than Majin Buu. And we know that General Rildo is stronger than the Sigma Force because they're saying that this is an impossibly huge key that is coming towards them, and they felt the force of the Sigma Cannon. They know that General Rildo is the strongest. Also, he's the final villain, which usually that's how it works. The final villain is the strongest. And so, Base Goku is stronger than General Rildo, who is stronger than the Sigma Force combined, who potentially each member of the Sigma Force was stronger than Lord Lude, who was Lord Lude stronger than Super Saiyan Goku. And this can make sense because several months happened between Goku fighting Lord Lude and Goku fighting on M2 for Goku's base to be now stronger than his old Super Saiyan form. It would actually be much stronger. Now then we get to the fight of Goku versus General Rildo, where Rildo would transform twice and Goku would transform once to Super Saiyan, and they were pretty relevant in power, so General Rildo's final form was essentially relevant in power to a Mastered Super Saiyan Goku. Now I'm going to go through and do some of the math to try and sort of power scale. I gave you a relative scale showing you of who is greater than the other, who is weaker than the other, and I'll go over that once again. So we start off with Super Saiyan 3 Goku to Base Goku. We get Base Goku being 400 times stronger than Base Goku from Dragon Ball Z because of his base form being stronger than Buu, who was relative to Super Saiyan 3 Goku. Then we get Goku training for 5 years with Ub. Now, if we take 5 years of training and you get 20 times stronger, then if you get 20 years stronger over another 5 years of training, that would be equal to 400, which is what we got for the previous 10 years, so I split it up. But realistically, it would be a greater level of training because Goku is training with Ub, who is Majin Buu level. But still, we'll lowball it to 20 times stronger. Then also multiply by 500 for Goku going Mastered Super Saiyan, and let's say that Lord Lude as a lowball is twice as strong as Super Saiyan Goku because Goku's Kamehameha would not do anything to him, and usually, or at least what we've seen, is Kamehamehas are at least twice as strong as the ki of the user, and then the Sigma Force, let's say they're roughly equal to Lord Lude, and then when they all fuse together, that makes them roughly 4 times stronger as a lowball fusion. And then say that General Rildo is twice as strong as the fusion of the Sigma Force because he is stronger than them. And then we'll go multiplied by 500 because General Rildo's final form is roughly equal to Super Saiyan Goku. And you get the final number to be that General Rildo is 320 billion times stronger than Super Saiyan 3 Goku from Dragon Ball Z. Super Saiyan 3 Goku from Dragon Ball Z. So, General Rildo is extremely strong. Now, would he be stronger than Super Vegito? I doubt it. I don't know. It's kind of hard to gauge because, I mean, base Vegito could shit on Buhan, and then Super Vegito beyond that was much stronger, but we don't really know the exact power of Vegito. Now, I would say that even General Rildo's regular form would absolutely crap on Buhan, and let alone his final form. So, I don't think really putting Rildo at anywhere close to Majin Buu is really accurate. He should be far, far stronger than even Buhan in Rildo's regular form, and then his final form being much stronger than that. But anyways, guys, so what I kind of got is that General Rildo, 320 billion times stronger than Super Saiyan 3 Goku. Now, let me know what you think. Again, GT's scaling is just kind of weird. It doesn't always make sense, but this is just the scaling that I've done, because General Rildo was an intimidating villain. They said he was stronger than Buu, and then he transformed on top of that. But he really, Goku, that statement really didn't make sense, because technically, Lude and the Sigma Force all should have been stronger than Buu as well. But I think this is just what Goku was saying to know that this final villain of the saga was stronger than the previous final villain of the previous saga. But let me know what you guys think. How strong do you think that General Rildo is in the show? Do you agree with me or do you not? And do you think he's actually a lot stronger than you previously thought? Because I used to think that he was Majin Buu level, around the power of Majin Buu, but now I don't see it at all. He can't be, like I said. You have base Goku, who is now stronger than Super Saiyan 3 Self. Then he trains for 5 years. Then he gets to the point where his base form is much stronger than a Super Saiyan form that was already much stronger than Super Saiyan 3 Goku. And so I just don't see how Rildo is anywhere close to Majin Buu in power. He should be far, far stronger. But anyways, guys, let me know what you think. Please do leave a like if you enjoyed. Comment, tell me your thoughts. Subscribe if you are new. Join my Discord so we can talk about this and see what you think about General Rildo. And also, guys, please turn on notifications and also follow me on Twitter. And thank you to all of my Patreon supporters. So my Super Saiyans is Hodag Hunter, and my Super Saiyan 2s, Dariush, Israel Flores, Locke, Anime Paradox, and Mystic Ghoul. And also, thanks to my Super Saiyan 3s, Scotland Serenity, Diraj Payton, Sin Overlord, and Griffin Jacob. And thanks to my new Super Saiyan, Daniel Toro, my new Super Saiyan 3, Dante's Ware. Thank you guys so much for all the support. It really does mean a lot, and I hope you guys all have an amazing day.